What is up, ladies and gentlemen? It's your boy, Rome.
Shemeka.
And welcome to the 21st episode of Gospel Ride Along. Yeah! Well, y'all, this is our last episode where we just celebrating, y'all. And today, we are celebrating all the graduates of the class of 2021 on the 21st episode. Let's go ahead and give those graduates a round of applause.
That's a huge accomplishment.
That is, especially in the time that we living in.
Yes, these kids came through a pandemic. Mm-hmm. These kids came through being on virtual in the building, didn't know if they was going to even get a chance to have a graduation. Mm-hmm. And so this episode is dedicated, like Jerome said, to all the seniors, whether it's tech school, trade school, college, university, high school.
Even some of the kindergartens.
4K.
The kindergarten graduations.
5K. The babies. We're just going to celebrate all the graduates 2021. We're not going to call no names because we don't want to forget anybody. Mm-hmm.
And what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and get right on into it. Because y'all don't know, but we've been pretty busy with Rome's World.
Yes.
We're doing a lot of more things, which we're going to disclose later on for Rome's World, which is why Gospel Ride Along has not been dwindling away, but has been pushed back just a little bit, because God has been blessing us with some more ideas and some more things that are coming in the near future. And we just went ahead and took the time while we could to get those things together. And now we are back with Gospel Ride Along.
Ooh.
Gospel Ride Along, y'all.
Ooh.
Because in this month of June, not only will this be the last celebration episode, but this will also be the month where we start Pastor Appreciation.
Yes, yes, yes.
Pastor Appreciation starts this month.
We got some awesome, awesome pastors coming on to give you the word along with their selections. That's mm-hmm. going to be awesome. And June will start Pastor Appreciation. So if your pastor is not featured in June, but you would like for your pastor to be featured in July, August, and so on, reach out. Inbox, drop it in the comment, text me or Jerome, get in contact. We would love to have your pastor and your church represented on Gospel Ride Along. But June will start Pastor Appreciation Month. I am so excited for that. And like Jerome said, we are working on some amazing things mm-hmm. for Rome World. We're about to do, I don't even want to talk about it.
We can't talk about it right now. Keep it under wraps. Keep it under wraps. Tell nobody. But I think that's everything we're gonna cover.
For the announcement.
Oh, want to give a special shout out and a big thank you to Mr. David E. Lucas of David E. Lucas Speaks for all the work that he has been doing behind the scenes with Rome's World and for Rome's World. We have some big stuff coming with him as well that we cannot disclose at this moment.
I'm gonna say it one more time.
But without further ado,
I want to say one more announcement, Joe. I think the people need to know this.
Come on, let's go
and
ahead.
And I'm not bragging because he's my child, but I have to say congratulations to Terrence Ketter,
mm-hmm.
who received the 2021 The Heart of the Red Fox at Hartsford High School. That is one of the highest honors you can get as a senior at Hartsford High School. And the reason why that moment is special, because Terrence and his brother mm-hmm. made history. Jerome received it in 2018.
Mm-hmm.
So if my record serves me correctly, I think they are the only siblings
to win the award. to win the award. Out of all the years the award has been given out.
I want to think that is correct. That they are the first siblings to win that award. And that is one of the highest awards that you can get from, besides your diploma, that is one of the highest awards you can get from Harsh for High. So I just had to give a shout out to my son, Terrence Ketter, 2021 recipient of the Heart of the Red, what?
Fox. That's everything?
I think that's everything.
Well, without further ado, we're going to go ahead and get this thing started. But before we get this thing started, we want to just let you guys know, please make sure that you like, comment, share, and most importantly, subscribe. Because if you're not subscribed to Rome's World, then what planet are you from?
And I also want to thank everybody for showing, I'm not sure what episode it was, but it was, I think it was TK's birthday, where Aiden represented TK. Everybody, thank you for showing my baby some love. He appreciated it. He appreciated it. Even though he took a little nap, everybody felt like that was cute. So we thank y'all for the support of that episode.
And while we going on ahead and talking, y'all, we want to say we got our hand sanitizer. We got our mask. And we also have some Lysol so we can spray this car down and thoroughly get rid of these bacterials. Bacterials. But we're going to go ahead and get into it.
Come on,
Miss Ketter, would you mind leading us in a prayer?
I don't mind. Dear Heavenly Father, once again, we come to you just to say thank you. We thank you for waking us up this morning, starting us on our way. God, we just want to say thank you for all the graduates that will be starting a new journey in their lives. We pray protection and covering over them on whatever path that they choose to take. In Jesus' name we pray, amen, amen, amen.
Amen. Let's go ahead and get these seatbelt songs so we can be safe, y'all. Now, y'all, we ain't gonna keep y'all long on this episode because, like I said, we just celebrating. And plus, we just got to get y'all caught up with what's going on in Rome's world.
And we know everybody's getting ready for different graduations and stuff. You know, you're celebrating your family, you're celebrating your neighbors, your bonus kids, your baby kids.
Y'all got cookouts and parties y'all trying to get to, and we're trying to do the same. So we ain't going to keep y'all too long. We're going to go ahead and let y'all enjoy y'all graduates.
Because we are enjoying ours, Terrence Ketter.
Every day.
Yes.
Every day.
So I know you enjoying yours.
Oh, we forgot something too. And we want to give another shout out to Mr. Marlon T. Ketter because his birthday has just passed, and his birthday was June 4th. So we want to give another shout out to Mr. Marlon T. Ketter on a happy belated birthday, my Uncle Marlon!
My brother, the baby of, he's the baby boy because there's a baby girl. So we cannot say enough about Marlon. Marlon is the glue sometimes. Marlon is the tape sometimes. Marlon is a big part of the village and the support system. So I have to just tell my brother that I thank him. I appreciate him. And you're getting old, son. You're getting old. You're getting old, son. Not seasoned, but old. You're getting old.
Seasonal. Now let's go ahead. And y'all, this song right here, I came across off of TikTok. You know, like you say, we celebrating our seniors. And, you know, we just, you know, just having a good old time. So I think it's only right that we play something that appeals to the young generation's taste just a little bit. Just a little bit. And this right here is a young guy that I discovered, like I said, off of TikTok. And I came across his music and he just blew me away because he's smart. He uses his rhyming skills and his knowledge of the word to reach those who are in the same age range as him. And that's something that we need more of in the church, is us youth being more active. And you know, a lot of people, they have controversial aspects when it comes to Christian rap or rap music in general. But like you say, you have to reach people where they're at. You have to meet them where they are. And this guy has come up with a system that has put him at the top, in my book, almost next to Lecrae, of being one of the top Christian rappers out there. So this is Caleb Gordon, all the way from Orlando, Florida, with his song, On Me.
You won't see me in the lobby. Everywhere I go, I keep the spirit on me. Yeah, white on, got me feeling godly. I protect what's in my spirit and my body. Lord, keep your light shining on me. Will I follow you? Guess it's on me. Will I follow you? Guess it's on me. All on me, it's all on me. Hey, will I follow you? Guess it's on me. It's all on me. Hey, will I follow you? Guess it's on me. I know you know me, won't leave me lonely. I won't ever dare to leave. Came a long way from my heart on my sleeve. From the top of my head to the sole of my feet. Yeah, I know who I am, I know who I be. Letting in, understand, I'm starting to see. Only you can provide that missing piece.
Universal Studios down there in Florida. And that's a young kid coming straight out of Florida. Okay. Straight out of Florida with that. And you know, there's a lot of Christian rap artists who are out there who don't consider themselves as a Christian rapper. And the biggest question is, why not? Don't be ashamed of your faith. You know, don't be ashamed of your faith. And that's one young man who is not afraid to put his faith in his music. Because he lets everybody know in his music, if it wasn't for God, he wouldn't have the mindset to even do music. So let's go ahead and give him something right there, because he's out there doing something that young kids don't want to do sometimes in their life anyway, and that's go ahead and give God the praise at an early age. And while we on that topic, I remember I posted something on my Facebook a couple of days ago where I said, just because somebody didn't find Christ as quickly as you did doesn't mean they aren't looking. So that goes back to what we always talk about in our gospel ride-alongs a lot, is that don't judge nobody's walk with God.
Hello.
Don't judge nobody's walk with God. Because like you say, he and this young kid, he talks about all the time about how when he was doing music, he used to do it for views and for the fame. But now he just does it to glorify God's name. Like that rhyme, you know, that rhyme.
I like that rhyme.
Glorify God's name. And
I taught you something.
You taught me that?
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Yeah, I did. That still goes in with the theme with the young folks on their graduation, always stepping out on faith and not doing what other people wants to please them. You now on your own journey. You're now starting a new chapter where you're not under mama's wings or daddy's wings or whoever took care of you wings. Now it's time for you to leave the nest. So now you need to know the Lord. You need to learn how to step out on faith, and you know that you have him if you don't have anybody else. Because now there's a new chapter, there are doors opening, and you're on your own. A lot of you are going to be stepping out this on your own. You're going far away from home, and you're not going to be in arm reach. You're not going to be in telephone reach. You're not going to be in car distant reach. So when it gets to that point and you can't get hold of family, learn to lean on the Lord. Mm-hmm. And that's why I always tell people to learn to pray for yourself. Mm-hmm. Because now, prayer. You get lonely, pray. You get stressful, pray. He'll hear you. He'll hear you when we can hear you. When mama ain't there, pray. It's okay. It's just a new, it might seem scary now. Because you finna do something you never thought you would be able to do, and it came around so quick. Mm-hmm. Them years came around quick. So it's okay if you're scared. It's okay. It's okay. Passion, path, and faith will take you a long way. Put God first, young people, in this journey. Mm-hmm. Class of 2021, 2121. Put God first in your journey, wherever it may take you. Put God first.
That's it. We ain't gonna talk too much, y'all.
No, we're not.
We're gonna keep it going with our next song, I Just Wanna Praise You.
I just wanna praise you.
Oh,
on now.
That song that stirs in your spirit.
Come on now.
Because I want to give a shout out and a dedication to the parents that put your kids through high school, college, whatever they did. It only got to be about the children. I want to celebrate the parents too, Jerome. You understand what I'm saying?
Uh-huh.
Because parents, without God, I know sometimes, without praying, I know sometimes you didn't know if you was going to ever get to see this 2021 graduate. It takes a lot to raise a child. It takes a lot. And then people start to stray away from the village. I don't want you to say nothing to my child, but parents, you did it. Village, you did it. Support system, you did it. You did it. You helped got those kids through it. So we have to just give God the praise and the glory. Because I know there have been plenty of times I had to call on that man.
Come on now.
Not just because I have a senior who grew up, I'm just telling you, doing those, what, is that 12 years? Sometimes they start at 3K, 4K, however long ago. It ain't always been easy. I need to say that one more time.
Come on now, tell them again.
Ain't always been easy.
Because
you had to, there's some things that you had to sacrifice to make sure that baby had. When nobody else did. When that baby looked at you, you had to provide. So parents, I want to salute you for all you did to get your baby through. Celebrate yourself too. You did it. We did it. Celebrate yourself and give God the praise and tell him thank you.
That's what you got to do.
You tell him, thank you, God, I did it.
That's
I made it.
Do.
My son made it. My daughter made it. My grandchild made it. Whoever, they made it. And without you, God, it would not have been possible. And I say, I thank you.
Come on now.
Lord, I thank you.
Come on now.
That you saw my child through that first chapter. Now he moving on to that second chapter, that new journey. God, I thank you and I praise you. And I thank you for it. Jerome, I ain't finna get started in this car today. Because we'll be longer than what we plan to be. Because you know that thing stirs in my spirit. Because you know what? Because I'm a single parent. So I know how some parents feel.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Come on now.
I know what some parents had to go through.
You stirring.
And I ain't trying to knock nobody who got their dad in their household or their mom, both of them in the household. That ain't what I'm saying. But the single parents, y'all know what I'm talking about. You know the sacrifices you had to make. So I ain't gonna get on that one, Jerome, because see, that's another whole episode right there by itself.
So we're gonna keep it going.
Keep it going.
Y'all.
Celebrate yourself, people. Parents, guardians. You did it. You did it.
We have Million Little Miracles.
Okay.
By Elevation Worship and Maverick City.
Okay.
Which is a nice song off their album, Old Church Basement.
Okay, here we go. I don't think I heard this one.
I like this song right here. Because this song is personal. The guy who's singing it is very personal to him.
It's personal.
Personal.
It's a personal message.
All my life, I've been carried by grace. Don't ask me how, because I can't explain. It's nothing short of a miracle I'm here.
Just listen to the words he's singing.
Some blessings that I don't deserve. I've got some scars, but that's how you learn. It's nothing short of a miracle I'm here. I think it over and it doesn't matter. I know it comes from above. I've got miracles on miracles. Thank you.
Like he said in the song, he has some scars, but that's how you learn. And that's what the young folks out there need to understand. We only but so old right now. 21 years, 18, 19, we only but so old right now.
Is that proper ELA?
Only but so old right now.
I'm about to check with some ELA teachers about that one.
We only but so old.
But it sound nice, Jerome.
It do. We only but so old.
And I ain't only but so young.
We only but so old, y'all. And we got a lot that we still are yet to encounter.
Mm-hmm.
We still got so much to go through. Some of us at 18, and that's something we need to understand, too. Sometimes we don't think about some people's situations and the young kids and the young adults out there. Some people became young adults at the age of 14 because you just don't know what they had to go through. could have been in a house full of 12 and had to help raise kids by themselves when mama and daddy wasn't there. Some people had to grow up with life quicker than others. So a lot of people had to go through a lot at the young ages. But there's a miracle within that struggle. There's a miracle. There's a blessing within that struggle. There's a lesson within that struggle. And that's what we got to understand. Like he's saying, every day is a brand new miracle. Every day is a brand new miracle. You may be sitting on the verge of thinking about, I just can't do it no more. I just want to give up. Father God, I can't fight this battle no more. That's when God tells you every time just to dig deep and fight one more time. Just fight one more time. Before you give up on me, I want you to know that I'm not going to give up on you. Fight one more time. Push through one more time. Go to that job one more day. Go to that school just one more day. Hang out with that person just one more time. Do that episode one more time. Write that song one more lyric. Put one more lyric in that song. God works wonders when you least expect them to.
I think we have to also, too, Jerome, take into account that parents, and they might get upset with me when I say this, just because your child come across that stage, that don't make them grown. Can I say that one more time?
Say it again.
Just because your child come across that stage, that doesn't make them grown. See, that's where a lot of people and a lot of kids get misunderstood and misconcept. Well, once he come across that stage, he grown. No, he's not. No, she's not. They still learning. Who's grown at the age of 18? And that's some of the age when they come across the stage. Who's grown at the age of 19? They're not. They still scared little children. Yes, I said it. They still scared little kids. So parents, we got, as parents, as young, as adults, as guardians, we have to get that mindset and stop telling them that. Let them know that they are young adults. Can I say that way?
Say it again.
Let them know that they are young adults in training.
Turning.
Let them know that they are young adults who still learning. Don't tell them that they are adults. Don't tell them that they're grown. Don't tell them that, because they're not. Because there's always something you can still learn. They're still in the learning stage. See, when you tell somebody they grown and they're adult, they shut down. They feel like they can't come to you. So don't tell them that.
Or they feel like they don't have to.
Yes, don't tell them that. Because they still need you. They still learning. They still babies. Come across that stage. Even at 21. I said it. Even at 21, they young adults.
It's okay not to have all the answers. But that's why God has put people in our lives to where, you know, I'm even tell it better like this right here. You know, I was at the service in my church last Sunday with Pastor Cummins, and he was talking about how Jesus prepared the disciples for 3 years. And then he sent them on their way and said, okay, now it's your ministry. It's time for y'all to go save souls. I done taught y'all everything y'all need to know. But not one time did he ever say, I'm leaving y'all. Not one time did he ever say, you on your own. He just said, I'm giving you the tools to do things on your own, but you're not alone. And that's how it is with us young kids and young adults in this world now. We think because we walk across that stage, we don't need mommy and daddy, grandma, uncle, whoever raised you, we don't need them no more. But in hindsight, the truth is, we're going to always need them. Because there's always something that, you got to understand, they didn't teach you everything when you was younger. Because it wasn't for you to know then. We handle stuff day to day on a day to day basis where we handle problems as they come along. You know, you think you got everything together, but think about it. Some of y'all out there finna get married and have some kids. Mm. Your mom and daddy didn't teach you how to raise kids at the age of 14. So you need to go to them and ask them. I know there's some people out there who just had babies now who still going to grandma, mama. This baby still hollering in the middle of the night. What do I do? What do I do? How can I get to stop hollering?
How can I get it?
Come on now.
Know what you say?
Yeah, it. That's what it is. A big it.
We're going to get into another song.
A big it.
Because we call the babies it.
We're going to keep it going, y'all.
See, we didn't celebrate having a good time, y'all.
Because whatever you need, God's got it.
We just having a good time.
Time to go to church.
Take us to church, Jay.
Just don't know.
Sometimes
now.
We have to swerve and park a little bit.
Sometimes we got to get on the side of the road.
Jerome, you got one more for him?
I think I got one more for him. Let me see.
We got one more? So, we weren't going to keep y'all long on this episode because we know everybody's celebrating their graduates.
Mm-hmm.
2021 graduates on all levels. So, we not going to keep y'all because we want to celebrate our graduate.
And this song right here is the last song. Maybe it might be less. I don't know. Whatever. We don't call it what God tells us.
We don't know.
I'm feeling good right now.
You feeling good?
I'm feeling real good. This right here goes out to all the graduates and everybody in life to let y'all know no matter what y'all going through, you got to keep on fighting. You got to keep on fighting.
See, I can't even get up on the road right now.
Oh,
just don't know.
Hey.
They just don't know.
Fat on.
They just don't know.
Keep on fighting.
Lord have mercy.
Yes, sir.
Lord have mercy.
Yes, sir. Jerome, that song stirred a little something.
What is stirring? What is stirring?
I don't know how we're going to work this episode, but you know when they say when God speaks to you, you have to try to make it happen.
Uh-huh.
I think we need to do an episode. It just stirred with me and my sisters.
Yeah, yeah.
They are Kim, Iris, Tanya, Vonda. So that's four of us. So that's five. I want to do an episode with my sisters.
Just y'all?
Just me and my sisters.
If we call five, that ain't enough for me then.
I don't know how we gonna make that happen.
We're gonna make it work.
That stirred in me. That song stirred that in me. That I wanna do an episode with my sisters. And my sisters.
We got to make that Rome's World gonna make it work.
We're gonna make it work. Maybe it may not be a ride along.
It might not be. It might not be a
Zoom,
sit-down
or
show.
Or sit-down or something.
Or a podcast. So it'll be something.
It'll be something.
It'll be something.
But I want y'all to meet my sisters. That stirred up in my spirit about my sisters. So I called them. Didn't I call them?
Yeah, they watch. I see them.
I see them in the back.
I see them
looking. Kim, the baby girl. Iris, the oldest. Then me. Then Vonda. Then Tanya. And then Marlon in the mix. But I want to do an episode with my sisters. So, John, we got this. That just stirred up in me. I know that it had nothing to do with the day, but you know that when the Lord speaks,
you got
to
go.
You have to speak on it.
You got to go with it.
Okay.
But, y'all, we don't want to keep y'all too long. We don't reach that mark. You know y'all celebrating. We celebrating. Mm-hmm. So we're going to go ahead and say thank y'all for tuning
thank
into this
you,
episode.
Thank you.
Y'all for steady keeping up with Rome's World and Gospel Ride Along. Because like we say, we got some more stuff coming, yo.
And what we say, don't
tell nobody. Don't tell nobody. Who knows? Y'all might be included in some of the stuff we talking about. There might be some individuals watching right now who I might call out and say, y'all going to be a part of this. You never know, because when God tells us to be a blessing to others, we're going to be a blessing to others. So y'all don't know. We might call y'all with some positions for y'all to have in Rome's World. You never know what's going on. So make sure y'all stay tuned and keep looking for what Rome's World is getting ready to do, because God has put us all the way in the middle, and he's not going to leave us right there. He's going to take us all the way to the top.
There are some amazing things about to happen with Rome's World. We are partnering up with some amazing people. It's in the works. So just like Jerome say, don't what? Don't
tell nobody. With so, that being said, y'all, anything else?
Once we get through talking, Jerome, I want to do a special prayer for a co-worker who's like a sister of mine's. LaShawn Johnson, she lost her nephew.
Okay.
So I want to do a special prayer for her and her family. And I still want y'all to keep my sister Tanya in prayer. We lost my niece a few weeks ago. So those two people, I want to just do a special prayer for before we close out. So if you're done, you know.
We go ahead.
You're done? Okay. Dear Heavenly Father, once again, I come to say thank you. I just want to do a special prayer for LaShawn Johnson and her family and my sister Tanya and the rest of our family. God, we both lost some people that were close to us who mean so much to us. We're not questioning your action, God, because you know best. I just ask that you touch them, keep them covered, touch their family, touch their hearts, God. Let them know that everything is okay. You have them now. They're in a better place. No more worries, no more pain, no more struggles. They're just resting. God, keep them covered. Let them know that you are there with them through this all.
Oh, yeah.
God, I know that it's hard because I have been there myself. Losing a child is not easy. Losing a nephew is not easy. Losing a family member of any sort is not easy. Their hearts are heavy. Their mind is soaring. But God, give them the comfort. Wrap your arms around them and let them know that it's okay. You love them. They love you. In Jesus' name, I pray. I pray. Amen.
And amen. I want to say a little special prayer, too, for everybody out there watching. Dear Father God, Lord, I want you to touch every individual that's watching this video right now, even the individuals who are not watching this video, Father God. I pray that you let them know that you are with them, Father God. Let them know that no matter what is holding them to a current situation where they cannot elevate, you are going to be able to break that chain. Because, see, we don't understand what you are doing until it actually happens, Father God. So I just pray, Lord, that you just keep working and you keep touching people and you keep saving souls, because you have never left the soul-saving business. Mm. Father God, I pray that you just touch everybody who is watching this video, Father God, because without you, we are nothing, Father God. We are just nobody's trying to tell somebody, tell everybody about somebody who can save anybody. Father God, I know that you're here. I know that you're in this car. Father God, I just pray that you go through this TV screen, this YouTube screen, this cell phone screen, to whoever's watching, who's ever listening, and you just touch them, Father God, and let them know, like I said before, that there's nothing that they can accomplish unless they have you. Father God, I just pray that you just let everybody who is binded by any sin, any change, any depression, any clinical, anything that's going on in their life, Father God, I pray that you touch them and let them know that you are the answer.
Yes.
Not nothing, what nobody else says. You see, we talk about this vaccine, but see, we don't have faith in the vaccine. We have faith in you, God, that you created the person to create this vaccine to help us, Father God, and we know that you will take care of all problems in due time, in your time.
Yes.
In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Lord have mercy. Y'all just don't know. God is working.
He is.
God is moving. God is moving.
Keep celebrating your graduates.
Keep celebrating.
Keep celebrating. I want you to love on them. All month of June, you love on them. Because that's a huge accomplishment. See what I'm working with? See? I'm going to put on my seatbelt.
Y'all. Without further ado.
Yes. Well, y'all, this is my last episode for a while.
For a while.
Y'all saw me the whole month.
I'm still gonna be here.
But this is my last episode until I'm invited back for a while. Wow. I'm getting out this seat.
And I'm back in the driver's seat. Yeah.
I'm going back to what I do best, behind the scenes. Working on some stuff, some projects and things.
Big projects.
Yeah, so I'll see y'all whenever he lets me come back again.
Well, everybody, it's your boy Rome.
And always your girl Shemeka.
And this has been Gospel Ride Along.